went online and I saw the description for promotions, and it said, like, what are you promoting in your life? And I was like, oh my gosh, there's like another way to interpret that word, because I have more firing stories than I have actual promotion stories. So the thing that I'm promoting in my life, it's kind of a weird concept, but I think it'll make sense. I'm promoting the idea of being really supportive as a parent with your kids' education. So parenting is full of surprises. And with parenting, like, sometimes there are things that you really want to be involved with, but you can't. And then the flip side is when you don't really need to be that involved, but then you get sucked into it. So an example of the first scenario is like when I want to jump with my daughter at the trampoline park, but I can't because they separate people by age, but mostly by size. So if I really wanted to jump, then I would have to jump with like the large children and teenagers while my daughter's like off over there with the small children, and I just never did that. So, so an example of the flip side of that is like I never really expected that I was gonna be that involved in my daughter's education, quite honestly, because my parents weren't really that involved with mine. I mean, other than the hundreds of thousands of dollars they spent on it, they really didn't do much. They just would occasionally like offer me a $20 bill if I got an A, and then tell me how lazy I was when I didn't get an A. So that was the extent of their involvement. So I just thought it was going to be like that. I thought I was just going to put this thing on autopilot and just let it do its thing. And boy, was I wrong. So my daughter started getting like really crazy low test scores, and we kept getting like emails from her teachers. And so it was starting to get kind of concerning, and then we had like a team meeting about it and everything. And then I totally empathized with her. I was like, oh my God, I sucked at reading like she's in third grade. I totally sucked at it. I sucked at it in fifth grade. I mean, I just faked the funk. So then I was like, I'm like really obsessive, and I go really hard into like research and stuff. So I'm like researching, like, how do I help my daughter? She's struggling in school, you know, what do I do? So anyway, I'm researching all this stuff, and I come across dyslexia, and I never really knew what that was. I remember when I was little, my mom had a crush on Tom Cruise, and she was like, oh my God, she's Spanish, she has an accent, oh my God, Tom Cruise is dyslexic. And I was like, what's dyslexic? And I was told that it was when you can't read or when you read backwards. And then I like imagined Tom Cruise like sitting in this little room with his assistant, and the assistant's like reading him the script and he's memorizing it that way. And of course he can afford that because he's Tom Cruise. Then I was like, what did he do before he got famous? Like, who was reading his scripts for him then? But it turns out that's not actually what dyslexia is. So I'm like reading more about it, and I just start, like I had like a eureka moment. Like, it's a really weird thing, like realizing as an adult who like suffered all the way through law school and the bar exam to realize, like, holy shit, I'm dyslexic, and now my daughter inherited it. So that's like so crazy. And her education is, it's not gonna be on autopilot at all. It's a fucking stick shift. And I don't know how to drive a stick, but for my daughter, I would figure out how to fly a spaceship, so.